What's up, developers? In this video, I am going to review the course that started it all for so many of us. For nearly 500,000 people, kicked it off, just sparked that flame. It's the Web Developer Bootcamp by the one and only, the godfather of Udemy, Colt Steele. Is this course still relevant, still worth your time in 2019, though, going into 2020? We're going to talk about it, and the video starts right now. I'm a self-taught software developer. I'm behind the mic today, showing you guys the course that started most of it. I don't know if I want to say it started it all for me, but it really got the ball rolling, and it got me motivated to learn more and more about software and web development so I could eventually get a job in the field. And this course played such an essential role in my success. Just again, you know, motivating me and showing me some concepts I don't know how else I would find under one roof. I see Udemy is back to their scare tactics. Don't pay any attention to that. You probably shouldn't be paying more than $15 for this course. I'm sure there's coupons out there somewhere. Don't let this fool you. The Web Developer Bootcamp by Colt Steele, now a few years old. These metrics are absolutely out of this world. With an overall rating of 4.6, 138,000 plus ratings. This is really hard to do as these numbers over here go up. And it has steadily maintained 4.6 or higher since I took it. And I do come back to this course every couple months just to see what's been updated, because there are more and more people, more and more creators and instructors making courses like this. And honestly, the Web Developer Bootcamp by Colt Steele is the gold standard. When a new online Web Developer Bootcamp comes out from any other instructor, it is by default compared to this course. This is the blueprint. This is the OG. Now, somewhere in this course description or in one of the intro videos, Colt tells us that this is the exact same content he uses for his in-person boot camps in San Francisco. So you're paying 10 bucks for what would normally cost 15 grand. I gotta say though, if I was an in-person student and a student of Colt Steele's in San Francisco, I'd be really wondering where that $14,990 is going. Like, is that for networking? Like, if this is the exact same content. Fortunately, I don't have to ask that tough question because I took this one on Udemy. The promise and premise of this course is that you can learn full stack web development in 46.5 hours of video. Some articles thrown in here, some good resources for a good mix, and also some projects that are really fun. Now, what separates Colt Steele from the rest of these folks, in my opinion, is that he's lively. He has a stage presence. He makes learning fun. A lot of Udemy courses, whether it's a boot camp or not, you're just not getting that connection. Now, some people don't mind that. They're just in it for the material. But I think it's safe to say that a lot of us, you know, you need to be presented this material in an engaging way, in a fun way, in a way that makes you want to participate, in a way that's motivating. And Colt has one of the recipes to make that happen. Let's go over some ingredients in that recipe. For one thing, there is a nearly half hour introduction to front-end development. So you're not just like diving right into, okay, here's HTML and here's CSS. You do get a little warm up. What is a front-end developer environment? And getting that stuff set up. And then you smoothly segue into the more technical stuff, starting with the real basics, HTML, almost an hour dedicated to that. And the projects, whether it's HTML and even going further, I don't want to get too much further into it just yet, but just any project, no matter if it's way in the beginning or further on, they're mostly fun projects. There's something called Patatap. It's not really a drum machine. It's more like a sound simulator. There's Yelp Camp. That's the full stack project you work on. But even like the HTML stuff you're doing, Pokemon tables, just fun stuff. And he has like funny cat memes and little bits of humor here and there, just to remind you that it doesn't have to be death by PowerPoint. Let's go into the course here and lecture 5. I found it just by coincidence. My boot camps cost $14,000 and $21,000. This is a brand new boot camp for a fraction of the price. The other thing that makes this course such a cult classic, or shall I say cult classic? I know I'm terrible with terrible puns and I love them. I'm sorry. The other thing that makes this course a classic is that the lectures are very digestible. Very tempting to throw 4 and 5 lectures like these first 5 right here, the Pokemon exercise, into one video. And he realizes, as a teacher, you're going to see a lot of students drop off and lose interest, like right about right here, if this was a 25-minute video. So this video, HTML tables, 6 minutes. The Pokemon exercise, 1 minute. So really early on, you're able to get some positive feedback and build some very simple things, but colorful things. I mean, look at this first-gen Pokemon chart. Pokemon is not even my thing. But these drawings, these illustrations are really colorful. It's a relatively straightforward project. If you're totally new to HTML, this is going to be a challenge. You know, you've never seen tables before. You've never seen any of this stuff. Putting images on there and formatting this stuff, that's a challenge. But you get through it minute by minute. And that is one of the things. And I think that is just one of the big features of this course. And you can see this super digestible style. Well, mostly this is like a 15-minute video right here, CSS colors. But for the most part, it's pretty digestible. I'm going to pop back over to the sales page because it's easier to see how this course breaks down. So two big sections to HTML and then two big sections on CSS. These are big warm-ups and these are great to get you ready for Bootstrap, which is a CSS framework. So over 5 hours dedicated to HTML and CSS. This 46.5-hour course, when I first went through it, I think I took a little less than half. I knew some of the stuff in here and other stuff I just couldn't get through. So I'm like, I'll learn it some other time, some other way. I finished just less than half, and I was doing this thing almost every day for about 3 months. Now, the time dedicated to it varied from, you know, 10, 15 minutes to 5 and 6 hours. But it did take me a few months just to get just under halfway through it. So expect to spend a lot of quality time with this thing if you're hoping to get that certificate of completion. If you don't get the certificate of completion, it's not that big a deal, but there is something validating about getting 100%. So after Bootstrap, you're going into JavaScript. Again, whopper sections broken down into digestible lectures here. Variables, 6 minutes. Primitives, exercises, 3 minutes. Primitives themselves, 13 minutes. Okay, a little longer. JavaScript console, 3 minutes. And then after that, section after section dedicated to JavaScript. Control flow, 1 hour, 21 minutes. Functions, 1 hour. Arrays, and then DOM manipulation into jQuery. This is something I am very glad Colt Steele kept. I know he and a few other instructors are adamantly opposed to quote-unquote older technologies like PHP. They won't touch PHP. And I'm surprised jQuery is still in here, but I am glad it is still there because jQuery is very much still relevant in 2019, 2020. And then right around here is when you take that step from front-end and then kind of going into the backend basics, which is an hour, so that's good. Just kind of warming you up for that, and then getting into Node, server-side frameworks, and then starting with the Yelp Camp project, which he doesn't call it a capstone project, I don't think, but it pretty much is a capstone project because you're working front-end and back-end, you're deploying it on Heroku, and working with authentication and RESTful routing and all this other stuff. Also, a nice little touch here at JavaScript, the tricky stuff. This is stuff Tony Alessia talks about at length in his exceptional course, one of the best on Udemy, JavaScript, the weird parts. So I think this is Colt's take on that course condensed into an hour. You've heard me ramble for a few minutes just about the course content. You've heard me ramble about these digestible chunks of lectures. You've heard me ramble about how great instructor Colt is. But you know what? This course has been out for a few years now. And some people certainly are wondering, is it still relevant in 2019 going into 2020? There are some things I do think that are missing from a modern developer bootcamp. Are they mission critical? Perhaps in some circumstances. Here are the two big things that are missing from this course. Now, the astute-minded will have noticed no mention of ES6 anywhere in these JavaScript basics. Now, granted, ES6, a lot of this stuff is not basic, but a little section on ES6 I think is really necessary. I think it is really missing from this course. The other thing that is missing, but not so pressingly as ES6, is a front-end framework. It could be Vue, it could be Angular, it could be a library like React that we call a framework. I'm not trying to get into semantics here. I'm just trying to cover my bases. But it could be Svelte, it could be Chew, not included in this course. And I think in 2019, 2020, to call it a bootcamp, to call it the only course you need to learn web development. And right now, React is where it's at. Even if it's an hour introduction, just getting people exposed to some basic concepts. What is React? Why would you use it? How would you use basic things? And what are some basic terms? Maybe even a good place to plug Colt Steele's own React course. Maybe like an hour sample from his React course in here somewhere. I think would be an excellent touch, integrated into Yelp Camp even, for a truly full stack experience where people can experiment with something like React. Is that a make or break? I don't think the framework is a make or break. The ES6 is really pushing it though, but I absolutely do not want to let that ES6 thing, that little hiccup, take away from the status of this course. I mean, this is an absolute classic course. I talk about it every month in one way or another. It's changed people's lives. Like I said at the beginning of this video, for me, it inspired me. It helped me. It did not teach me everything I needed to know, by no means. Mm-mm. Not even if I went through 100% of this course, would I even be remotely close to knowing 1 or 2% about software development and web development. But this is a great introduction to the basics, and you're building some really fun projects, and there's a fun, knowledgeable instructor at the wheel. Just to give you an idea of how massive this course is and how deep it goes, look how many questions there are. 54,734. Like, you need an army of people to answer all these questions. This course is a little old, but it's not that old. It's only a few years old. 54, almost 55,000 questions. That's absolutely insane. And look at, these are just fresh. I'm doing this review in October 2019. These are fresh, okay? 16 minutes ago, missing schema error. Sir, can you please include the React framework also for the front end part? So some people are actually asking this too in the question and answer, so I'm not the only crazy one here, guys. But again, don't let that deter you from investing in this course. And I say invest rather than purchase, because this could be the gateway. Is it true I'm lavishing praise upon this course? Yes. However, there are some really good competing courses when it comes to these all-in-one web dev boot camps on Udemy. Andre Negoy's Zero to Mastery is absolute fire, as is Angela Yu's. Now, Angela Yu, I haven't really talked about. I'm going to be doing a review on her bootcamp soon, along with her iOS course. Both of those are fire. But Angela's version of this bootcamp is, it's almost like a clone with her personal touches. And I'm going to talk about that more in an upcoming video. So there was like a sense of deja vu going through her course, because I'm like, wait a minute, didn't I do this project like 3 years ago with Colt Steele? So there are a lot of variations of a theme. And honestly, a lot of this stuff with the bootcamp, you have to talk about no matter what. You have to talk about HTML. You have to talk about CSS. You got to do JavaScript. You got to do DOM manipulation. All this stuff, up to the point of like the Yelp Camp stuff, you have to talk about. All in all, the Web Developer Bootcamp is a stone cold classic. It does have its imperfections. One of them to me is starting to be a glaring imperfection, but by no means does that ruin this amazing course. 46 and a half hours of high quality education for the cost of lunch. Again, these are some scare tactics. Absolutely do not listen to this. I know so many people are watching this right now and have their own opinion. Some people are going to say, Candy, stop it. You're being way too fangirl with this course. Other people are going to say, Candy, you're right on. Other people are going to be like, yeah, you suck. So I'm curious what you guys think of this course. What has it done for you? What hasn't it done for you? What are your thoughts on Udemy as a platform? Let me know what you think. One of my favorite parts is reading the comments and just seeing what other people are saying, and it helps me make better videos as well. 5 stars out of 5 stars overall. Guys, it's an absolute classic.